Hi, welcome to Game Dev Box with another paid assets review. In my previous assets reviews, some people have said that I'm sponsoring this assets. That's not the case. I reach out to assets developers and respectfully request a review. To clarify that I'm not doing sponsorships, I have adjusted the videos to show you exactly what you want to see from a review. First, I will show some footage and provide a description of the assets. Then we will look at some projects by other creators who have used this assets. After that, we will dive into features and techniques to see how it works. Finally, I will give my personal opinion on whether the assets is worth it or not, with full honesty as a developer has allowed me to review it. Today's asset is Creator Environment by Creator Entertainment. So reviewed another asset of Creator, which was 3D pixel camera. You can check that out on Game Dev Box. So as I was saying, after using the package for a few days, I can say it's an instancing shader tool, different from Nature Renderer or GPU Instancer. It gets the job done, but it's not directly comparable to those tools. It's a toon shader tool designed to enhance your natural and stylistic environments. The features include instancing leaves on mesh and grass on train, outlines, custom lighting, clouds based on 3D noise, toon shaders, and a water system. It also works well with their 3D pixel assets. Please note that this assets only works on URP, Universal Render Pipeline. The first thing that came to my mind when I saw this assist was, I don't know how to pronounce it, who is creating an unbelievably technical game. The two main scripts are Terrain Instances Behavior and Mesh Instances Behavior. Terrain uses 4 channels of one texture to render certain elements on specific parts of the terrain. For example, grass could be rendered on a grassy texture and rocks on a desert texture. Can use the first layer input to define what gets instanced on the red channel of the control texture. Control texture color channels are RGBA. Density controls how many instanced meshes appear. The configurations define an array of meshes and materials that are instanced. For example, a grass texture can include both grass and flowers. Probability defines the chance of a configuration being chosen for a certain point. A scale determines the size of the mesh. You can also introduce randomness by adjusting the position and scale variance. The distance offset pushes the points in the direction of their calculated normal, multiplied by its value. Now you put the mesh here and create a material using the instanced billboard shader, which will be used for instancing. I will discuss the shader settings later. In the red channel of the texture, which is green here, we place some grass and flowers. remember to disable the draw instanced option in the train settings. The train also has a material connected to the toon train. Here you can set surface options or splat texture colors. I believe this setup is only capable of handling 4 layers for train. But if anyone or the developer can confirm, that would be great. The toon ramp includes shades, brightness, and minimum darkness. Cloud options. The clouds use 3D simple noise to create a cloud-like texture. Just play with the numbers to achieve your desired effect. Mesh instances behavior script can limit the points calculated to cover only a certain submesh. For example, if we want to spawn instances only on the leaves of a tree, element 1. The toon shader is another shader with parameters similar to those we have seen, but it includes outlines, which we will discuss later. There is a trees game object with tens of trees. This trees game object has a parent instances behavior script. According to the documentation, this will lower batch calls and material instances, optimizing the game. If you have many game objects, just group them under a parent and attach this script. The next one is custom lighting. Again, toon shader for structure and objects. The water shader only works in orthographic view. You can adjust the foam amount, scale, speed, water transparency, distortion, reflections, and other parameters. To use pixel outlines, add the pixel outline setup feature to your renderer feature. The pixel outlines are intended for low resolution 3D rendering. For example, when you used with the Creator 3D pixel camera assist, this ensures that the outlines on objects are 1 pixel thick, resulting in a stylistic look. This is done by calculating outlines from differences in the depth texture and normal texture. So these are all the features. Also, you can create your own custom behavior. You can check the documentation for more details about the assist. I used some other packages to create this scene, and it looks very cool. Who will benefit from this asset? Developers who want to create a super stylish effect will find this asset valuable. Nowadays, the graphics and uniqueness of a game are really important. This asset will make a significant difference in your project, especially if you don't want to create all the shaders and tools yourself. I recommend this asset for developers who need its features in their projects, want to create a stylistic game or want to learn from it. Also check out their YouTube channel for great videos and join their active Discord channel to ask questions. If you buy the asset, please leave a review to help others see how it functions. I'm currently busy with a project that I have been working on for a year now. If it weren't for this project, I would have made a small game with this asset. I've always wanted to create something pixelated in this style. Thanks for watching. Don't forget to hit the subscribe button and like the video if you enjoy it. See you next time.